So another misconception is that a lot of people believe that teachers are all-knowing. Teachers know everything. Hello and welcome back to my channel. This is the episode 2 of Misconceptions That I Think Parents Have About Teachers. If you've not watched the first episode, I encourage you to watch it. I'm going to put the link to it on the screen right here. And if you've not subscribed to my channel, I'd like you to consider subscribing to this channel. So let's get into these misconceptions very quickly. So I'm going to continue from where I stopped in the last episode. So in this episode, one misconception that is really crazy is that a lot of people think that we have a very long summer break, so we just go back home, we relax and we do nothing until we resume the next session. And I think that's really wrong. And my reason is this: when teachers conclude a particular term, then a lot of activities lined up for them. They start to plan again, and then they plan so hard to meet children who have gathered academic cobwebs, like we say, so that they can clear it off their head as they resume for the new session. Then there's a lot of trainings that teachers go through, on a lot of professional development training, a lot of senior leadership training that I have to also attend. There's a lot of training during the holidays, and the holiday period is usually a time that you have to do all of this, and then you have to work on your lesson plan, scheme, curriculum, your new subject. And if people think that we have long summer or long holiday and we do nothing about teaching and learning, no, that's when we even work harder. So another misconception is that a lot of people believe that teachers are all knowing. Teachers know everything. Okay, nobody is an embodiment of knowledge. Nobody knows everything. We know in part, we know some things, we know in part, but then I've come to understand that what stands a teacher out is the fact that you understand the skill that you need to help a child learn. So if you are a rocket scientist, it doesn't mean that as a rocket scientist you have the set skill to transfer your knowledge to somebody who is coming to learn rocket science. But I know that as a teacher who is not a rocket scientist, you can learn the skills that is needed to teach rocket science, and then you pass the message effectively to somebody who wants to learn rocket science, but then you aren't a rocket science yourself, but then you would pass the message across to somebody who wants to learn rocket science better than even a rocket scientist who has this knowledge of rocket science. I don't know if that makes sense, but that's what stands a teacher out. You can, as a teacher, teach anything as long as you have the template that you're supposed to work with and you have the set skills that you would need to pass the learning across to people that are listening to you, or people that you're tutoring, people you're teaching. So that's what stands you out. And it doesn't mean that a teacher is all knowing. Now, another misconception is that a lot of people think that everything that teachers want to teach is prepared for them. You have a curriculum broken down into a scheme, broken down into a plan, and then you have a template for your plan, and then you go into a class with already made instructions that you want to teach with. And that's why a lot of people think that this is really easy. After all, you have all the things that you need. But that's not true. You have to plan from the scratch, from the very beginning. Plan, and you keep planning it, and then you have to come up with all the skills and set knowledge that you need for a particular lesson. So as you're going to sleep, your head is working, you have behavioral management also to do, you're an expert in your field, you have children that you have issues to deal with, that you also have to deal with as you teach. Then you have to also plan for children who aren't learning the way you would want to teach or you would expect them to learn you. So you have to learn the way these children learn. So it's really very crazy how that we teach. And then you have to sit and plan for these children. And that's really very crazy. So if you think that it's very easy as a to become a teacher, it's just very easy because we have a set template for us. No. The curriculum is just supposed to be a guide so that everyone is on the path, we understand where we're going and we understand the vision of what we're doing. That's what the curriculum, all the scheme is all about. But then you have to get into the classroom and become the MD CEO of your class by setting out the instructions that you need for your lesson. Interesting to know, a lot of people think that we recycle lessons. If you taught primary 3 last year, it means that this year the instruction that you use for that last primary 3 class is what you're going to use for this primary 3 class. Wait, you're making a huge error, because you're going to meet different children, and you'll be shocked, flabbergasted, perplexed, and confused at how that your old plan is going to be shattered right in front of you because you're meeting new learners. So it's important that as a teacher, you plan for every set of kids that you meet, because you have to plan for an ABC and plan differently for an XYZ. In another class, you may not meet that ABC, you may meet a different child. So you have to keep planning and putting into consideration every child that you have to teach, because every child is expected to learn. So you see, you can just keep recycling every time that you teach. So that's another misconception that I think a lot of people have about teachers that needs to be corrected. Another huge misconception is that a lot of people think that some people became teachers because of isolation. That's true. There were some people who became teachers because they thought that it was really, really easy to be a teacher. But those people, believe me, are out of jobs. Because they do not understand the nature of this work. They do not understand the complexity in teaching. They do not understand how demanding teaching is. So they get in and they feel that, because they feel that it is easy, they feel that it has an easy schedule, they feel that every day they should have time out whenever they close. But then they find out that even when you're out of school, you're still working as a teacher. Teaching is part of you, because you're thinking about the child, you're planning for someone, you're marking, you're scripting, you're commenting, you're working, you're giving results, you're giving feedback. You have a lot of schedule on your hand, and then a lot of people wake up and say, see, I can't do this, I thought it was really easy, and they quit teaching. So that's a misconception. If you come into teaching, for example, because you think it's very easy, then you have to really think again. So if you hope to be a teacher, if you want to be a teacher and you're watching this video, I'd like to categorically to you that is not as easy as you say it from the outside. A lot of people think that it's that easy. It has an easy schedule, you go to work by 8 and by 2, you're out of school, you're home, having your own time. No way, that's not true about teaching. So work hard on yourself, set start if you want to be a teacher, make sure that you really want to do this, because it's not as easy as it looks, it's not as easy as it is presented. There's a lot to learn, it's a lot, lots to do. You're not resilient as a person, and you're not preparing yourself to be resilient to face the challenges of teaching and learning in the classroom. I think you should rethink becoming a teacher, because it's not as easy as people make it seem. So on that note, I conclude this episode of misconceptions that I think parents have about teachers. So subscribe to my channel, click on the notification bell, that way you would get notified when I drop that video. So if you really would love to sign with me, I'm dropping this video very, very soon. Until I come your way next time in another video, it's bye for me.
If you're new to my channel, click on the subscribe button, tap on the notification bell, like it, comment, and share. Thank you.